Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this series, we will be talking about some accidental inventions that changed the world. So the accidental invention that we are going to talk about today are microwave ovens. So let's get started. Microwave ovens are a necessary appliance for the modern household. It cuts down the amount of time spent in food preparation. It is a blessing for the modern day kitchen. So how did this wonderful invention come into being? The story is an interesting one because of the accidental way in which it was invented, due to the curiosity of a hard-working man. Percy L. Spencer was born on 19 July 1894 in Howland, Maine, USA. His childhood was a difficult one. His father passed away when he was very young, and his mother abandoned him to the care of his aunt and uncle. After his uncle's death, financial constraints compelled him to drop out of school at the age of 12. Young Percy worked at a spool mill to support himself and his aunt. Although without a formal education, Spencer was intelligent and he was determined to succeed in life. By the early 20th century, some factories in the United States began using electricity to operate their machinery. Spencer came to know that the local paper mill was about to be electrified too. He immediately applied for the job and started learning everything he could do about electricity by himself. In 1910, materials on electricity were very rare, and he had to rely on trial and error. He was selected despite his lack of a degree in electrical engineering or any degree at all. After working at the paper mill till the age of 18, a historic moment in history changed the course of his life. In 1912, the sinking of the RMS Titanic shocked the world. Spencer drew inspiration from the stories of bravery exhibited by the crew aboard, particularly that of the radio boys. He enlisted in the US Navy and enrolled in the radio school to learn about wireless telegraphy and wireless communication. His time in the Navy established him to be a valuable asset. After being discharged from the Navy, Percy Spencer briefly worked for the Wireless Specialty Apparatus Company in Boston. There, the curious young man often stayed up all night figuring out how things worked. Between the late 1920s and 30s, through hard work and determination, the grammar school dropout from Maine had become a leading expert in radio tube design and worked for Raytheon. Raytheon was an independent defense company working as contractor for US Department of Defense. It was Spencer who played a key role in obtaining a government project to produce combat radar equipment at Massachusetts Institute of Technology's laboratory. During that time, vacuum tubes called magnetrons were used to produce microwave signals for the functioning of radar sets. They were vital for warfare and played a great part in making the Royal Air Force more efficient. However, producing the equipment was a slow and laborious task, and an average of only 17 magnetrons could be produced a day. Spencer improved on the equipment by ingeniously coming up with a better device and was able to increase production to 2,600 per day. Whenever others saw a problem, Spencer would see an opportunity as he tinkered away in his laboratory to know the reason behind things, working the way they did and how they could be improved. This was the quality that would lead him to his most famous invention, the microwave oven. While producing magnetrons in the laboratory, Spencer noticed that the candy bar he had in his pocket had melted. This was unusual because candy bars were not supposed to melt at room temperatures unless exposed to heat or sunlight. It piqued his curiosity and he became intent on finding out the reason behind this strange phenomenon. He wanted to find out more, and so he sent an assistant to bring out popcorn kernels. As he placed the kernels near the tube, moments later the kernels began to crack and pop, and they became the first microwave popcorns. He knew that he was on the verge of discovering something and conducted more experiments. The success with the popcorn kernels led to a series of experimentation with other foods. Spencer also came up with a new idea in which microwave energy was fed into a confined metal box. Engineers at Raytheon began working on the prototype, and on 8 October 1945, the company filed a patent proposing the use of microwaves for cooking. However, these units were not as portable and affordable as they are now. They were bulky, expensive, and 5.6 feet tall. One unit was approximately $5,000, which would have been an enormous sum at that time, and owing to their sizes and their cost, these ovens were mainly installed only in restaurants. It was only a matter of time before its efficiency would make it an essential kitchen appliance. After several tests in 1947, the first commercial microwave oven called Radarange was introduced into the market with a price range of $2,000 to $3,000. Although the initial response to the appliance was not positive, further improvements were made and it rapidly gained popularity. 1967 saw the introduction of the first countertop oven. In 1958, Don Murray, in his Reader's Digest article, Percy Spencer and his Eats to Know, described his meeting with the ever-curious inventor. Spencer had made Murray take his shoes off so that he could examine exactly how they were made. This was the kind of curiosity that made him chance upon an invention that was to help mankind in their culinary endeavors. The orphan from Maine rose to the position of senior vice president at Raytheon and continued serving as senior consultant until his death in 1970 at the age of 76. Despite his humble beginnings, Percy L. Spencer was able to forge his path through sheer grit. During his lifetime, he held more than 100 patents and was awarded an honorary Doctor of Science degree from the University of Massachusetts and the Distinguished Public Service Award from U.S. Navy. He also became a Fellow of the Academy of Arts and Science and a member of the Institute of Radio Engineers. In 1999, Dr. Percy Spencer was posthumously inducted into the National Inventors Hall of Fame.